And a very good early morning to you, ladies and gents. I'm filming this one early before it gets busy. The Georgian Dragon. The Georgian Dragon was built in 1720 on the site of a much older inn dating back to the 14th century. It is one of the most unusual inn signs in England. A large oval sign depicting St George slaying the dragon. A sign which is probably as old as the inn itself. It is not very far from the Hellfire Caves, the site of Francis Dashwood's diabolical orgies in the 18th century. The Georgian Dragon is haunted by more than one ghost, but Suki, a former servant at the inn, is the most famous resident, who met her end at a visit to the caves, though she wasn't tempted there to join one of the Hellfire Club's notorious orgies, according to the commonest telling of the tragic tale. So, across we go. There is that sign. And we go through under here where the horses would have gone. These areas here were the old horse stables and where the ostlers slept. And those are dovecots or pigeon coops. They've got one up there as well. Probably in the days where they kept pigeons and doves for pigeon pie, as I shall say later on. This is its car park. And when you watch the West Wycombe Park video, if you watch it, I'd advise you to. If you're into the paranormal thing that I'm going to be following or enjoying this area, watch this one, because it is amazing in there. Absolutely amazing. One of the most beautiful country house grounds I've ever been to. And I've been to a few since I started the page. Great Dixter in Sussex, Great Dixter House being my favourite, of course, because it's where my ancestor lived. Sir Nicholas Tufton, knight and sheriff. And if you're wondering how I am no longer a sir or a knight or a sheriff, it's because Sir Nicholas Tufton's great, great, great grandson married a servant and got himself disinherited and died a very happy man at the age of 89. We assume he was very happy. They was married for 67 years, so, and they had 15 children. So that would hint towards a degree of conscientiousness in that degree. And you can't really hear it that well at the moment, but at night time, when you sit here and have a smoke, you can hear the sound of rushing water. And I wondered what it was. Well, I found out yesterday it's a weir, a little tiny river and weir through there, and they open up its sluice gate at night time. It runs during the day as well, but is more noisier at night time. And now we should go inside the pub. I asked and of course was given permission for this one. And if you're ever thinking about visiting the area, either for a day or for a little holiday, all I can say to you is come and stay here. One of the most friendly welcomes I've ever received. Really lovely. And the food is very good as well. I had a cheeseburger last night, which I must say I thoroughly enjoyed. It was really nice. Over here is its old water pump, which they even converted years later to take a proper tap. So that's where the pub's water would have come from to brew its beer. That's one of the stables there, and this is where the ostlers used to sleep, the ostlers and horse keepers, stable lads, whatever you want to call them. And in we shall go. Look at those old beams, look at the history they must have seen. The Jocund Peasants, this is called. St. George was for England. He was indeed. And this beam up here is from the original fireplace, which they do light in the winter. This used to be the original, one of the original entrances into the pub. It's disused now. West Wycombe Park. Crisis of London. HRH Prince George. I'm not sure, but wasn't he the one that was killed in an aeroplane crash? A rather suspicious one. Oh, I like this, look. It's a King Charles Spaniel wearing a monocle. This was painted by one of the customers a few years ago. It's very good. Crisis of London, oh, it's the same one, they match. Francis Dashwood's home. Now, Sir Francis Dashwood, even though being a great lord, he did often drink in the pubs in town here. From what I gather, he seems to have fairly much enjoyed as well with mixing with the aristocratic classes, mixing with the ordinary classes. It was once rumoured to, I found a reference to it online, that he advised a friend of his to take the company of both learned men and of the ordinary classes, for they be good sport and good company. The crisis of London again. And here's its dining area.
nice view as well from the back window. It's lovely. Really is a lovely pub, as I say. And if you're in the area, even just for a day, just pop in, because you'll really enjoy it. And as I said, the food is absolutely delicious, so I can really recommend the cheeseburger. That was really nice. Let's put my flash on. Right, and here's the original old flagstones here. And another one of its fireplaces. King James and King Louis, the Sun King. Where's that? Somewhere in London, but I can't make out where it says. Well, ladies and gents, think of the history that these have seen and people walked on. I hope you all enjoyed this one. We're not over yet. And we climb up the staircase now that the ghost of Suki and the murdered gentleman is said to walk up. You join me at 1 a.m. in the morning for this one, when everyone's asleep. I think. And the beams and everything in this place, just amazing. And now we walk a path above the entry point where the horses would have gone into the stable yard. Good old Henry. Looking down into that stable yard. Up here. And that brings us out onto that very staircase.
And on the the subject of nighttime and stable yards and such like.
And I do like to show places by their nighttime and daytime aspects. And you'll see the George now at nighttime. The pub is closed. But the hotel, of course, is not. And we go under the arches where the horses once would have gone. It's the old horse stable yards and dovecots above there. There's another dovecot over there, or pigeon loft. Whatever they happen to be keeping and eating at the time. A lot of the coaching inns, the old ones, would have something like this because, don't forget, you would have pigeon pie and things like that, which was a much more popular dish in its day than now. This is the car park, of course. Here is the George in its nighttime aspect. And it is very cold. That isn't smoke, it's not me smoking, that is the mist from my breath where it's turned very, very cold. Well, I hope you all enjoyed the tour of the George, ladies and gents, and the back of this one, and this pub will feature again in our paranormal evening. So I hope you'll all find that interesting, a two-day special. So I hope that's all going to be something that some of you like. So thanks very much for watching. And now, join me as we head off back into the past for some historical images. Hope you're all going to enjoy. And here we are, the 1880s and the High Street of West Wycombe. If you've watched the tour video of the Plough pub, you will have already seen this picture with the Plough over to the left and the Georgian Dragon over to the right, of course, marked with a blue arrow. And interestingly enough, there are two barmaids there. It's later than the era of Suki, but it gives a little reference as to her and maybe what she would have looked like and been dressed like. Our next image is 1906, and you can see, of course, marked out of the blue arrow there, Georgian Dragon. There were more pubs here at one point, but there's only three now. 1955 for this image. And the Georgian Dragon over to the left. Hasn't changed all that much, has it? 1954 for this one. It shows its part of its frontage and the sign. That sign that you just saw, the big oval one, that's inside now. And we saw that down in the pub, in the main bar. It's so old that they brought it in. And the one that's outside is old and old looking, but it certainly isn't as old as that. 1954 again for this image, and again 1954, and you can see it was a very, very big sign as well, so I suppose really it's lucky they took it down, otherwise it would have been stolen or possibly blown down in the wind. 1954 again. ...1968 for this one, and that's, of course, shows the rear of the pub, which hasn't changed all that much either, I must admit. And here is the newer Georgian Dragon sign, still on its original old mount, and bracket, but yeah. So, I hope you've all enjoyed this one, ladies and gents. Thanks very much for watching.